Hey y'all, it's gonna be a you versus them reading, so we're gonna see what is going on with you and the person on your mind, all right? So let's see their current energy. Whoever it is, it could be your divine masculine, it could be a family member, friend, boss, coworker, whatever it is. Let's see the person on your mind's current energy. I'm actually gonna wanna use another tarot deck too, but I'm gonna start off with this one here, okay? All right. Person on your mind, their energy. Ten of Swords reversed. All right, so there's been some betrayal. They're either in denial about it or they do want to heal it. If things ended, they want to revive things. They don't want things to be over. They don't want to let go, but perhaps they also don't want to let go of a betrayal. Okay, let's get one more card on that. Queen of Cups. They do care about you. This is Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio. They feel maybe in tune to your emotions, and they might reach out to you here. This is Sagittarius, Aries, or Leo. They're still very curious about you. They're still caring about you. This person definitely doesn't seem to have that many like negative feelings towards you, to be honest. My dog is in something, so she's making a lot of noise. This person also might deal with some depression, or they don't really see the light. They don't really see the truth. They might feel like when you exited their life, the light went out in their life. So I do feel like in some regards, they need you to see the light. Could be a Leo that you're dealing with. We got a lot of cards here, I'll take them. They don't wanna fight with you. They don't wanna have any fear. Like they wanna let go of negativity around your dynamic. They do wanna communicate with you. They don't wanna be isolated from you, but also their Ace of Swords reversed. See, there is a little bit of like lack of being in tune to like the true self, or what with the High Priestess reverse. I'm going to use another tarot deck to get clarity on that. Could be a little bit of shady energy. They're not being honest with you about something. The High Priestess upright would also be not being open and honest, but the High Priestess reverse could be a little more sinister. So could be dealing with a fire sign, Sagittarius, Aries, or Leo. I think there's a lot of themes in this dynamic coming up about confidence and standing in your magnetic power here, okay? A decision, juggling energies, and walking away. Okay, you could be dealing with a Capricorn, Taurus, Virgo. There's a lot of anxiety here. So I don't know if this is, I didn't ask actually for these cards if it was your energy, but I see someone walking away here. I see someone really just like standing in their personal power and perhaps also finding like a match. But this is like someone who's really confident, really like inspirational, and then someone who's really grounded. So I also feel like if you haven't met this person yet, you could have someone that's like a really good partner, and you guys kind of even each other out, like you bring different things to the table. Let's see what you currently feel towards this person that you're dealing with, the person on your mind. What do you feel? You don't feel like there's a connection. You don't feel like a emotional like reciprocity here. You feel maybe you can't trust them. You can't like confide in them about things. And you also might feel like it's like a done deal. Like there's not really anything left to talk about. There's not really anything left to say here with the world, a Capricorn energy. Right, we're gonna get a couple more cards here. You feel like you're at the end of a cycle of some sort. It could be like a personal cycle, but I feel like it's more towards with this person. Okay. Sorry guys, I'm always hitting my phone when I do these readings, like it's too close to. All right, so what does this person want to communicate to you from their higher self? Sorry guys, I'm so sorry, it's so annoying. It's annoying for me too. All right, what do they want to communicate to you? Breathe. Maybe you just need room to breathe. There could have been like a codependent aspect. Breathe, instinct, and broken. You know, I'm hearing like water under the bridge or building a bridge and getting over it. Let's read what these have to say. I ran away from you because I was afraid. I've given my heart before and my heart was broken. I don't know how not to run. All I do is run from love. It's gotten so used to the pain, I'm almost numb to it. Maybe, just maybe, I'll give it one more try. Okay. The stars instinctively know when it's time to come into alignment. It doesn't need to be manipulated and helped in any way. It just falls into place when it's meant to, just like you and I. I was drowning in my sorrows before you came into my life. I didn't think I would ever be able to come up for air again. A broken heart that's broken twice can slowly kill you if you let it. Thank you for rescuing me, for helping me to finally exhale. I just heard that song coming through. Everyone falls in love sometimes. Sometimes it's wrong, sometimes it's right. For every win, there comes a point when you will exhale. It's called Waiting to Exhale, Shoop Shoop, from that movie with Whitney Houston. There is some sort of like, this person does look to you to almost rescue them. They're very broken. This is just like this instinctive thing they do, and perhaps it just doesn't work well with you. Perhaps it gets you like off kilter. Perhaps, you know, with the Queen of Wands, you're just trying to be confident. You're just trying to be in your power. And there's something, there's an element with this person that knocks you out of that, okay? And you maybe feel like you can't breathe, and they look to you to be able to breathe here. Let's get from the romance angels, I'm feeling. You could switch it, you could flip it as well if that doesn't resonate. So let's get some more energies between you guys from the romance angels. What else is there? Chemistry. We have instinct and chemistry. So there is like a natural connection here. There's a strong magnetic connection here. Playfulness. Sorry, guys. Playfulness. To recapture romance, allow your inner youthful spirit. I feel like this is what you guys need to choose. Like, you need to choose someone that you feel chemistry with, that you feel playfulness, that brings out the best in you, and perhaps it's going to come through separation. Time apart from your partner is on the horizon. So if this person isn't making you happy, if they're stressing you out, I just feel like you need to choose you right now. You need to choose playfulness. You need to choose people that it just works and it just feels like a match, and you need to separate from energies for right now of like that bring you down, because I feel like if this person is drowning, they might be trying to like pull you under, and it's just like someone's broken here and it's not your job to fix them, and that's something inside of you that you need to heal. Keep an open mind. Your soulmate may differ from your usual type and expectations. All right, guys, I hope this reading resonates with you guys. Thank you for tuning in, and I'll see you next time. Bye.